Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Please be seated. On behalf of the University of Strathclyde, I welcome you all here today to our Barony Hall. The Barony Hall is one of our main buildings in the University of Strathclyde campus. It was given to us by Glasgow City Council a number of years ago, and it was an old church. And it's got some fantastic architecture. You can see behind us, but if you actually look behind you, the stained glass windows are really fantastic. And you'll also enjoy the UK's only Bach-style organ in existence. And that's wonderful, and another wonderful part of the university. The Barony Hall is unusual because we're a socially progressive leading international technological university, and our buildings are state-of-the-art. We've invested over £1 billion since 2010 on the campus, and that campus has grown quite considerably and transformed over the last 12 years. But the Barony Hall is unusual because it's different, and it's a link between a present of a technological university and the past, which is our origins. Now, I'm very delighted today that we've got a special guest. We have our convener of court, Dame Sue Bruce, and she's attending this graduation. And it's a big graduation, as you can see. We apologise for the delay. We had a number of people who attended late, and we had to arrange the parchments so that we didn't get them out of order. In a few short minutes, our graduands will be coming up onto this stage, and they'll be capped using this quite an old hat here, an old cap. And that's a symbol. It's a symbol of a change in the life of our graduates. It's moving from a student and then to be capped. And they're no longer a student. They're a graduate. And they're a member of our Strathclyde alumni community, which numbers nearly 200,000 people all over the world. And it replicates the international nature of our cohort. Today we have PhD graduates from all of our departments in the business school. We also have our master's programs that we run throughout the year, and those master's programs are taken from the business school as well. And we have our marketing department undergraduates as well. So it's a very eclectic group, but it represents the nature of the University of Strathclyde. So it's a special day. A number of us only get to graduate once. Lucky few get to graduate twice, and then a very special few get to graduate three times, and we do have those today. And it's special for the graduands, but it's even more special, I think, to the family and the friends and the loved ones and those who have actually come here today and are sharing with us this special day. And it's a bit like a wedding. My daughter graduated last year, and it's something that we'll never forget. And so for everyone who's here and joining in this celebration, please approach it as if it's a wedding. You know, celebrate when your loved one, your family member, your friend comes up. You know, celebrate in your own way and make this a really special time that's unforgettable for all of us. So without further ado, I now declare today's congregation for the conferment of degrees open, and I invite Professor John Quigley, the Vice Dean of Strathclyde Business School, to present our graduands.
Executive Dean, in the name of the university and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students for the degree of Doctor of Business Administration in Management Science: Al-Mansouri Saif, Marim Sarif, Al-Rada Saif. For degree of Doctor of Philosophy for Research in the Department of Accounting and Finance, Pawel Henrik Zarnowski. Christoph Giatourlidis. Mehran Shane Abbas Rajwani. For research in the Department of Economics, Gabriel Amobilo Eboy Adana. Ross McKenzie. Aristides Rafta Postolos. For research in the Hunter Center for Entrepreneurship, Ross David Kroll. Effie Princess Imeren. Zhur Sheo. For research in the Department of Management Science, Alina Isabel Bass. Bodunrin Nathaniel Brown. For research in the Department of Marketing, Sophie Helen Duncan Shepherd. Dodd Nair. Semi Sag Manley. Karina Sorocha Inska. For research in the Department of Strategy and Organization, Gokhan Gokman. For research in the Department of Human Resource Management, Sarah McDougal Clark. For research in the Department of Work, Employment and Organization, Johanna Murad Ali Al Mulaha. For the degree of Master of Research in Research Methodology in Business and Management, Thomas Scally. For the degree of Master of Science in Finance, Gagan Agrawal. Frank Agimang. Sejan Anil. Shresh Sabanik. Oluran Juwan Olum Idabello. Andrew Craig. Rushika Sheres Dom. Joylan Shalitha D'Souza. Mitra Fadakar. Rafael Der Fakayo. Rohan Shekhar Gait. Arpita Kamalakar Hedjter. Darstilip Jain. Aniket Nankishore Kamth. Osaji Eromoseli Ogbe. Olaleken Michael Ogunyemi. Ola Wali, Ola Dimeja, Ola Ya. Maria Omar. Akinteli Babatunde Omotesho. Shraddha Pandey. Sharayu Sanjay Pathak. Sudhan Su Prakash. Saji Matthew Ninen. Chandra Kanta Satish Kumar. Isha Mahesh Shinde. Abhinav Singh. Ileana Silikio Tu. Rahul Viswana San. In finance and management, Tianjung Gil. Ying Jia. Natalie Amol Mahamuni. Ishita Manohar Nawani. Ilaria Maria Teor. In international accounting and finance, Charles Oluwaseyi A. De Goroye. Shasib Ahmed. Monel Hare Krishna Ashiyani. Shashwat Mazumdar. Henry Yudoka Nidana. Meokun John Orim Oloye. Muskan Rani. Sheikh Mohammed Abdullah. Swapnil Kumar Subham. Sri Lakshmi Suras. In international banking and finance, Jamie Gallagher. In investment and finance, Di Dong. Rishika Rashkesh Kumar Jain. Yogita Aravind Kuyaba. Mikhail Papakaliastia Papakaliastakis. Pauline Ingwer Ako Tabot. Zidane Wakar. In Applied Economics, Antonio Pietro Fratamico. In Economics and Finance, Indetu Mbeakin Shamaki. In Project Management and Innovation, Mihir Adha. Tarinder Singh Kang. Abhishek Kumar. Abdel Karim Akram Zergug. In Business Analysis and Consulting, Abdullah Olam Ilek Anabu. Emmanuel Idoko Ad Eji. Unique Ba Gavatip Rasad Ba Joria. Namhiraj Barigali Vijali Akumar. Niraj Anil Vander. Bipin Ror Bar Gavin. Aniruddha Chatterjee. Nadim Sharakula Chandhari. Abhishek Somnath Chingel. Rithvik Chitamila. Goridila Preyal Damail. Pooja Erola. Vishal Gur. Uttam Krishna Gudeli. Niraj Milan Gulhen. Shefali Gusain. Ewan Hamilton. Jayanth Gauda Hanu Mantha. Amit Hukapa. Syed Shah Aman Uden Ilfran Nuden. Tanbur Jalil. Babatunde Onashiangbi Jeremiah. Arankudi Lum Matathil Vijay. Chaitrath Majunath. Ethul Thunalili Monoj. Anjali Mohan. Ambadi Mulamuti Rashish. Mohammed Hamza Nahim. Nguyen T. Tanvan. Nurasing Nuang Chamnong. Inualu Wapo Michael Ogandro. Tejavising Parehal. Anshul Sharendra Patel. Nachiketa Sayajir Eo Patil. Fantil Huang Teo. Sumit Padar. Rohan Visi Puleath. Sasmita Rani Satapathy. Fayez Ahmed Sheikh Abdul Siad Sheikh. Ruxar Ishad Sheikh. Yahya Fahim Sheikh. Ankit Kumar Singh. Kushagra Singh. Varun Singh. Saranja Krishna Sivaprasad. Ashwin Sujit. Aditya Sundaram. Nikhil Naresh Kumar Tanwar. Kyung Pang Thien. Renita Mariam Thomas. Snea Thomas. Shivani Valuru. Rohit Suraj Vuduta. Sevamsi Nanda Kishore Reddy Yeramanchi. In data analytics, Emmanuel Alexaski. Mohammed Anas Anasari. Arjun Prasad Duhungana. Saurabh Anil Jadhav. Sunil Kumar Jambagi. Vishesh Kulshesh Sa. Callum John Lockhart. Jack Lockie. Amo Guru Nash Gunda Patil. Kritika Singh. In global industrial management, Julian Rastero. in Project Management International, Xiaoyu Guan. Musa Meish Abdullah. In Innovation and Marketing Management, Yalun Huang. Joel Vargas Jose. In International Marketing, Caitlin Isabel Smith. In marketing, Shubh Agarwal. Mushtaq A. Hamed. And Mol Bansal. Niponika Batra. Gaurav Band. Sesha Se Mohan Chiti. Yuan Chien. Sarah Kate Doherty. Anna Jacqueline Forbes. Ife Fu. Isha Jane. Themaren Jungtrakwa Wee. Fanchi Leo. Nikita Ipashen Manik Athazi. Chitali Mehta. Anik Mondal. T. Quinn Mino. Oluwagbemi Sole Ejik Ogini. Babatunde Felix Aladele Ojomo. Shamik Pathak. Abhishek Gula Breo Patil. Akshay Vithal Patil. Michael Paxton. Manjunath Prabhu Kumar. Akshit Raghuwanshi. Pisini Robru. Surmar Salsabil. Kunanon Shantawisuk. Herman Singh. Shrutika Vinod Kumar Supar. Akhilesh Tandur. Thierry Age Taixan. Vedant Verma. Dihanesh Narayan Wakir. Sinyu Wang. Jiani Wang. Jianhao John. Uteng John. In Human Resource Management, Abhijit Bekalkar. Saffron Joy Courtney. Roisin Irvin. In International Human Resource Management, Saqib Ahmed Khan. Diksha Shandilya. Shraddha Sharma. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Marketing, Kia Bertoncini Gilmore. Matthew Gordon Douglas Farmer. Estelle Collins Balfour. Callum Scott Bendoris. Emma Hazel Campbell. Thomas John Everett. Gregor Forster. Nicole Jane Taylor Gatt. Leon Hanna. Grace Charlotte Heatherton. Luke Aloysius Jack. Logan Keir. Marcin Mamsura. Neve Olivia Mercruden. Aaron McGillivray. Hannah Mitchell. Ross Moyles. Jordan Robertson. Ben Alexander Craney. Robbie Gallagher. Cameron Hudson. Rachel Nicola McAdams. Ewan McMurray. Emma Monahan. James Alexander Ritchie. Martina Sebesta. Kira Andy Kohl Upau. Lewis Wilson. Ross Wilson. In marketing and business analysis and technology, James Cummings. Murray Charles Godsman. Adam Rose. In marketing and business analysis and technology with international study, Emanuela Adefulgi. In marketing and business enterprise, Kieran Lovett. In marketing and business law, Bryce Charles Hawkins. In marketing and finance, Joseph Craig. Lucianne Duffy. Amy Robertson. In marketing and human resource management, Finley Andrew Patrick. Amy Jane Torrens. Oliver Warden. Zhan Chen. Ross McDonald. Craig Stewart McIntyre. In marketing and management, Alina Afzal. Catherine Badbeer. Fraser Macrae. Safa Aslam. Cameron Clark. Nicholas Finley. James Andrew McIver. Lisa Marie Pascal Levieux. Abiha Arslan. Echa Kiata. Kaishin Lee. In marketing and psychology, Emma Lauren Heron. In marketing with international study, Christopher Allen Clark. Victoria Clark. In psychology and marketing, Olivia Charlton. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts in Marketing, Gian Luca Vezza. Thank you. For the degree of Master of Science in Marketing, Neha Tamnoir. Woo! for the degree of Master of Science in Marketing, Nicole Rail.
Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed guests, and most importantly, the class of 2023. It's an honour to preside over today's graduation ceremony, a momentous occasion that encapsulates a period of real commitment, resilience, and triumph. As once was said, success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. And you, the class of 2023, have embodied this spirit, succeeding where many would have stumbled, amidst the most disrupted period of learning since the Second World War, especially for our undergraduates who have had 4 years of study during the COVID pandemic. You've persevered and you've pushed forward, and then today you have triumphed. Supported by your classmates, your friends, your family, and the unwavering dedication of our university staff, you have indeed conquered formidable challenges. So let's take a moment to applaud your incredible resilience and accomplishment. Congratulations. Behind each graduate today, there is a collective force of loved ones and friends who have bolstered your journey. They've been your pillars, your lifelines, your cheerleaders, offering mental, welfare, and financial support, and often sacrificing their comfort for your success. Ralph Waldo Emerson said that the purpose of life is not to be happy. It is to be useful, to be honorable, to be compassionate, to have it make some difference that you have lived and lived well. And it is this essence of compassion and support that your family and friends and loved ones have extended to you. So graduates, let's express our heartfelt appreciation for their unwavering dedication and support. Thank you. And just as crucial to your success has been our diligent faculty and staff who've tirelessly tailored your educational journey, navigating the uncertain waters of the past few years. And their commitment and adaptability have proven instrumental in your success. So please let's honour their remarkable efforts for you. So as of today, you ascend to the ranks of our extensive global network of Strathclyde alumni, a number that counts to nearly 200,000 people around the world, and around 40,000 of those are Strathclyde Business School alumni. You're joining a lineage of distinguished individuals who've harnessed their Strathclyde education to make a tangible impact on the world. Since its foundation in 1796, Strathclyde has nurtured the vision of being a place of useful learning. Now, as you step onto a new stage, it is our fervent hope here at Strathclyde that you'll carry this spirit into your future endeavours. The challenges that lay ahead are undoubtedly daunting. We continue to grapple with the continuing impacts of a global pandemic, the repercussions of Brexit on the UK and the Scottish economy, We have a military conflict in Europe. We have climate change. And we have social and economic upheaval around the world. Yet it's at times like these that greatness appears. I spoke about the challenges that we've not faced since the Second World War. But the graduates of that time are what created the world today. And so it may be seeming daunting and challenging, but you are there to make that world different and to have an impact. And as Michelle Obama reminds us, she said that you should never view your challenges as a disadvantage. Instead, it's important to you to understand that your experience facing and overcoming adversity is actually one of your biggest advantages. You've had 100% success in everything that you've faced to get to this point today. Just remember that. And with your knowledge, skills, experience, values, and the backing of the Strathclyde staff and alumni community, you're more than equipped to navigate these challenges. And I want to just give you a little anecdote of what that actually means. 18 months ago, the university received a $70 million endowment from one of our alumni, from Dr. Charles Wang. Charles studied marketing in the business school. He then went on to do an MBA and a PhD. And when he left, just like all of you will do, he started his career and he met some challenges and some hurdles and some difficult times. But he always knew that he could come back to Strathclyde and to ask his staff for help and support. And that's when I asked Charles about this. He said, well, that's the reason why I'm giving this gift back to the university. It's because of you that where I am today. And Charles is the person whose company designed and produced the lateral flow tests that most governments used at the beginning of the pandemic. And it's another lesson for you that no matter what you study in the business school, whether it's finance or whether it's marketing, human resource management, business analysis, technology, management, any of the subjects that you're here for, you can apply that to any area that you face. This isn't just a graduate who's from a business school. You're a graduate from a leading international technological university that's expertise in many areas, and that alumni base have that expertise. So don't fear what you're going to face. You've got a great future ahead of you. And as you venture forth, keep close to your heart the core values of this university. Strathclyde has instilled in you the virtues of innovation, boldness, collaboration, ambition, and being people-oriented. And paired with integrity, humility, and empathy, you have the power to enact meaningful change. The Strathclyde degree that now graces your hands stands as a testament to your dedication and perseverance. It is a golden key that opens doors to a world of opportunities and success. And as you embark on this new chapter, remember that learning is a lifelong journey. Embrace new challenges, continue to evolve, and strive to leave a positive imprint on the world. And at Strathclyde, we swell with pride at your accomplishments, and we eagerly anticipate the greatness that you're destined to achieve. Like Charles, stay connected. And remember, you're not just leaving Strathclyde. You're carrying our spirit with you. You're the embodiment of the ethos that this great university stands for, of a deep-seated commitment to innovation, collaboration, and excellence. Strathclyde is more than a mere institution. It's a beacon of hope. It's a platform for freedom of thought, a proponent of tolerance, and an advocate of inclusivity. We trust that you will propagate those values as you navigate through your life's journey. You will remain champions of progressiveness, fostering an environment that thrives on diverse perspectives and inclusivity. And as a symbol of your achievement, the Strathclyde degree that you now hold is indeed a powerful tool. Use it wisely for it's not merely an emblem of academic excellence. It's an endorsement of the potential you hold to positively influence your surroundings. So remember that success isn't a destination, it's a journey. Keep learning, keep challenging yourself, and keep pushing the boundaries of your potential. Embrace the ethos of our institution that the acquisition of knowledge and the pursuit of excellence are lifelong journeys. We trust you'll make us proud and continue to contribute to the Strathclyde community. We look forward to celebrating your future achievements and witnessing the positive change you will bring to the world. And in closing, let us thank our exceptional faculty and staff once more for their extraordinary commitment and dedication. Their relentless efforts have been instrumental in shaping your path and guiding you towards your full potential. And to the family and friends of our graduates, when we talk about people being a Strathclyder, like I am, and graduating from this university, we don't just talk about the individual, we talk about their families. Once they're Strathclyders, you're Strathclyders. And we want to extend our sincere gratitude to all of you for your unwavering support and encouragement of our Strathclyde alumni community. And finally, to our distinguished graduates, our class of 2023, you've made it. You've risen above the challenges, surpassed the expectations, and today you are triumphant. This is your day, your moment. Cherish it. Remember the journey that led you here and look forward to the exciting journey that lies ahead. Carry forth our Strathclyde spirit of ambition, boldness, innovation, collaboration, and people orientation. Go into the world with confidence, with purpose, and with the knowledge that you are destined for greatness. I wish you every success as you step forward into the next chapter of your life. Thank you. So we had the digital signal at the back. It's a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Unfortunately, Glasgow weather has defeated us today. If you come from another country, this is an unusually bad day for weather. And if you come from Glasgow, you know what all Glaswegians say about the weather. So what we're going to do just now is that, given that we can't have an academic procession, we will, as an academic community, we will leave the podium and go down in an academic procession. We ask our graduates to follow us. The staff will move to the right, but we want you to carry on and go straight to the teaching and learning building, which you all know. And to our Strathclyde family, we want you to follow our graduates, and we'll see you at the teaching and learning building for some beverages and a chat. So without further ado, I now declare today's congregation for the conferment of degrees closed, and I ask you to be upstanding.